Today, I want to show you guys the most beautiful way to integrate the inverse tangent of square root of x. But I didn't come up with this idea, I want to thank my viewer for suggesting this. The idea is to use this formula, the integral of f of x is equal to x times f of x minus capital F of little f of x. And the capital F is just an antiderivative of the inverse of the original little f. I actually have a proof of this in the past, so I'll link that in the description for you guys. However, in my video, I actually worked it out as the integral of inverse f of x. But it's the same thing, you can just change all the red f of x as f inverse, it's the same idea. But I never thought about to apply this for this one right here, and you'll see that it's actually going to be so much easier. So, this is how it will work. First, our function is just that, right? So I will just start off by saying our function is inverse tangent of square root of x. And this is actually super nice because, well, as you see, we need the inverse of that. And this right here, square root of x is increasing. Likewise, this is also increasing. We do have a very nice inverse. So here, the inverse f of x, what we can do is just imagine this is like x, and then you apply the original tangent first, and then square both sides. So we actually just get tangent square x. Right here, we need to figure out capital F, and that's just the antiderivative for that, right? So capital F is just going to be the integral of tangent square x dx, and to integrate tangent square x, we can just say that's the same as secant square x minus 1. And that will give us tangent x, and that will give us minus 1. x. You don't need to worry about the plus c because this is not the whole thing. I'm just trying to integrate that, right? So it's just an antiderivative, so don't worry about the plus c here. Now we can just plug in everything and it will be done. So, ladies and gentlemen, this right here is going to be first, x times f of x. So I will just have x times f of x, which is inverse tangent of x. Then minus, I have to put little f of x into capital F of x. So I have to put little f of x into capital F of x, which is here and here. And so minus, so I just put parentheses tangent of the little f of x, which is this, and then minus inverse tangent of square root of x, and then plus c. That's pretty much done. And of course, we can do better because nicely enough, this and that cancel out. And then, ladies and gentlemen, we have x times inverse tangent of, you know, I just want to write this as our f of x as well. So this is our little f of x, right? So that, and then minus square root of x, and then minus minus becomes a plus, and then inverse tangent of square root of x, and we are done. Ah, how cool is this, right? So again, thank you so much for this idea. That's it.